Sweet, rape my eyes. When I awake, I'll see your light. When I awake, I'll see your light. Mark here. Look, if I come over and take a look at your exhaust manifold on your Dodge Dart, I got a piece missing somewhere on mine, and I'm not sure what it is. I want to see what you got on yours.
Throttle lever, strike dash pot rod. The rod must push diaphragm back, or it can move back. Air must be forced out vent. This causes diaphragm to move slowly. With throttle lever moved away, spring will force diaphragm out. Air will down vent. Dash pot is ready to work again. I don't care
what the rod that you're talking about.
I don't care what that looks like, Jerry. I'm telling you what the dash pot is.
Where's the dash pot on here, Jerry?
I don't know.
The dash pot is inside, Jerry, where it's hooked up at.
That is not made, not made to regulate the fucking choke going back and forth.
That's not the unloader.
That's so you can get pure fuel in there.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as you start cranking it over, it'll start sucking, and when it starts sucking, this choke here, because you can't just have pure fuel, you won't light, you have to have a little bit of oxygen, it sucks open and it cracks the choke like this. And that's how that works.
That is not what you just said.
I said, no, Jerry, the heating is the motherfucking spring. This one here, as soon as you start turning over the engine, it's supposed to pull it back when the vacuum starts. When the vacuum starts, nothing to do with fucking heat. Vacuum.
Why are you screaming?
Because you say, well, you said it's supposed to work on heat. No, Jerry.
You said as the car gradually warms up.
As it gradually warms up, this motherfucker with the coil, the spring, opens it up. This has already done its job. The only thing its job is to do is when you're cranking the engine off, after it's been choked, all it does is pull back and it cracks it open just a pinch.
Then you don't know what it's called.
The choke vacuum diaphragm. I mean, it's right there in the book. Oh, God. You're a hard, hard woman to live with.
If it was right
Jerry.
Here in the book, I would have found it.
Oh, you motherfucker, you asshole, you stupid son of a bitch. You showed it to me.
What, Mike?
You showed me the goddamn thing in the book, what it was called. That's why I knew what it was.
Get out of here and
put your arm. No, Jerry, you're fucked.
I haven't seen that.
I haven't seen it, you stupid son of a
bitch. That vacuum thing, yes. We don't know what the little business is. It doesn't explain anything. I haven't read anything that explains that.
I told you what it
did. Yeah, you did, yes, yesterday.
I just told you what it did. And you're sitting there saying you never saw that before, and you're the one that fucking showed me it, Jerry.
You stink like gas. I told you that fucking fuel filter was not on there.
Yeah.
It's not that fucking orange business hanging across the goddamn business.
Let's try rebuilding the fucking carburetor first, Jerry. Let me tell you something, Jerry. Let me tell you a little secret, Jerry.
Don't tell me any secrets. Be quiet.
I quit. I tell you something and you fucking don't believe me. You tell me something and you still
I can't show you anything, Michael, because your head is blank.
Well, you're sitting there telling me that motherfucker is dead. Well, that's not how it works. That's what Jerry, a mechanic told me that's how it works.
Who's talking about the truck? We're talking about...
A Dodge Dart. On slant six.
You have lost your mind.
What are you talking about?
My God.